So another Divi tutorial, and in this episode, I will focus more on the Divi blog module. Now, there are some instances when in terms of styling that you cannot achieve what you are looking for in CSS. So we need to use a PHP code, we need to use a filter to achieve what we want. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can modify the default dimension of the blog module in Divi, okay? So we will use add filter in this. I will also provide you the entire code for modifying the dimensions of the width and the height, and also like a brief explanation what that code means. Like I want to just rather just putting the code and instructing you to copy paste it into your functions.php. I'll try my best to explain with you what's the meaning of it. So without further ado, let's begin, guys. 1, 2, 3. Hi guys. So if you want to modified the dimension of the blog, so basically this is the default template or thumbnails for the Divi blog module. Now if you want to change this dimension, you want it to be squared, maybe you want it to be more vertical or more portrait style, the workaround of that would be using a filter. Now I will provide the code later, and I will put it on my article version. But before you go to my article, I want you to ask a favor, to listen to me and understand what's the explanation behind those code that you will be putting on the functions.php. okay, so this is the default, again, this is the default layout or default dimension for the Divi blog module. Now if you want to be something like this, like squared version or landscape, what you need to do is to use a filter. Okay, so the requirements or prerequisite on this is you need to have a child theme. Now if you don't have a child theme yet, make sure you check my video tutorial for more information about Divi child theme. Now I will pretend that you have already a child theme. Okay, so you go to the appearance and then theme editor, and then you go to your child theme and go to the functions.php and you paste this code. Again, this code will be put on you on my blog, so make sure you check my article version. This code, before you dive into my articles, I hope you can listen a little bit with the explanation so you understand what it's meaning. Okay, and this one, this is other way of coding using an add filter. There's also simplified version or simplified syntax, but yeah, I just like this kind of syntax, but it still depends on you. Okay, so first one is, the first step you need to do is you need to add filter. Now on our Divi blog module, we need to customize the width and the height, right? So we need to create two filters. Okay, add filter. Now this etpb underscore blog underscore image underscore height, this is the so-called filter tags. So this one is already inside the Divi theme. So basically this one has a different value. So the default value is like this and this one. So like it's the width is, if I screenshot that, so I believe the width is 300 and the height is 193. Now, as I said, I'll just pretend you want it to be perfect squared. So to do that, you need to create a filter. So add filter, and then you need to call the filter name. Okay, so the filter name will be etpb blog underscore image underscore module. Now in this area, again, I just forgot the name for that, but that was, let me check my copy. Okay, so this one is the hook name. Okay, so for the hook, you can use whatever name you want as long as it corresponds to the functions that you will create. Okay, so let's pretend I'm gonna call this one as blog underscore height. Now, after you created your filter, the second step is to create a functions. And again, since we will be modifying filter tag name, the height and the width, we need to create two functions. So like this one, if you notice here, they are both like the same. So blog height, blog width. Okay, so functions, the name of your hook, and then the argument. So as I said, we will modify the height of our blog module. Okay, so this is the opening and the closing. And then actually there's two ways to do this one. Okay, you can just do something like this. If you don't want that, you can just do something like that. Or for best practices, I would say I just want it to be understandable as possible. But I mean, the other one is also good, but it just depends on you. Again, I will put the code on the article version. Depends on you which type of code or which code you will use. So that's it. That it means in here that we are overwriting the default size of our height. So the default size of our height, if we inspect the elements again, I'll just pretend that it is 189 pixel. Okay, and we want that to overwrite to 500. So return is we are calling this height, which is equivalent to 500. So it's just something like that. But you can also do the other way, like just put return and the value. Okay, so again, we need to create two functions, the blog underscore height and the blog underscore width. Okay, the last part, or so the step three that you need to do, is you need to call the add underscore image underscore size. So you need to call that functions. We need to register the new height and width that we just created. Okay, so this add underscore image underscore size is so-called function. So if we copy this one and put it in Google, this is the reserve, like the reserve format, so reserve name for the for registering or adding an image size. So add underscore image underscore size, and this is the syntax. Okay, so you need to have a string, and then you can also use integer height or a boolean, true or false. Okay, but on our part here, we will be using an integer. Okay, so width and a height. So if you check here, like we are passing this argument height and then the width as well, width. So height is equivalent to 500 and a width is equivalent to 500. So it is perfect square. Now, I created another thing in here to make things a little bit more detailed, and I echo it out, but you can also do something like this. If you don't want that, you can also do something like that. Okay, you can also do that, but I just like this kind of stuff. So if you update that one, and let's refresh it. So this is, it's already perfect square. So earlier it was rectangle version. Okay, and also if you are curious, how did I make this one, like this one, scale, I mean bigger when it hover? I just added a custom CSS. I believe I call that, let me just pull the theme that options CSS. I think I put it in there. By the way, I'm going to put all my custom CSS into the styles the CSS. So, but yeah, I mean, I need to put all of the CSS to the to this child theme. Let me try to type in hover. So, okay, wait a minute. I call that, okay, so this one. So what I did is I created if I enable this builder, okay, and if I, let me just open this one, okay. So I created a ID of square blog, and then I added here like the image itself has a link, so I use A. You can also use IMG if you want, but I just use A. And then if it is hover, it will scale to 1.1, OK? okay? Or what you can also do is just click this design thing in here. You choose that image. Not image, but I think sizing. So sizing, and then let's look for the image part. Sorry, so imaged, and then I thought there is an image part. Oh, there's no options for that. But what you can, if you want this whole thing to be something like that without using a custom CSS, let's see if there's an options in here. You click this one, and then you choose this hover thing. Okay, you make the width, let's say 95%, and then you click this one, and then if it is hover, you want it to be 100%. So that's the other workaround that you can do. But like, I just prefer to just put a custom CSS because I don't want to go over again to its module if I want to put, if I want to change something. So I prefer to just put a custom ID or class, and then declare a custom CSS for that. So yeah, I hope that makes sense, guys. Again, I will also create a different version for this PHP thing. It still depends on you what syntax you are using, but I just want to explain with you like what this all about. And as always, thank you so much for watching. If you have any question, feel free to comment down below. I'm done.